The welcome to Martinez in the continuation of our terrace design that we are working on. So in the last episode we were able to start the roof and then put some of this elevation in order. So in this elevation, in this tutorial, what we want to do now is to complete this elevation at the front, especially the front side elevation, because this is the most only attractive of terrace building. So the side does not really matter in whenever you are designing terrace building, because it is a joint aligned building. So we have a lot of array of building here. So the only place that is more necessary and attractive is the front elevation and little bit of touching at the back. But back is not necessary because no one is seen there as well. So your central ceiling is this elevation. So that's why we want to base our knowledge based on the elevation proper. So now let us move on to the next thing. Go to the elevation. As you have seen, the ground floor plan is available. This is the way we did it. The first floor plan, if you are seeing this for the first time, this is how we create all those things you are seeing one after the other. If you want to master it, you can do as well as possible. And you can likely subscribe to our channel so that we'll be able to learn one or the other thing. So you have a channel references in every other thing we will do. Just Martinez Design, search on your YouTube and you get it done. So this is the elevation that we want to work on now. And quickly want to make sure that I toggle off the shadow. So I focus on this side I want to work on. So I'm using the same gauge and the pattern to which I want to work with this one. So what I want to do, all I just want to do is just to use what a design element to do everything I want to do. So click, go to foundation level, ground floor level one. So what you do, select this, the wall, and say create similar. So at the create similar, just create another wall at that point. So what you do here now, you go to elevation. So go to 3D, so you can see that properly. You can drag, if it's permitted to drag from that, you can drag from this, then to drag to the very top again. Good. So now you can go back and align it so that you have alignment towards the wall level. So say modify, then say align. Good. So go to 3D one more time. And the 3D, just like toggle to this area so that you'll be able to feel what you want to do. So what I just want to do is to create a little bit of pattern references towards this one. So I'm creating this, I will say wall opening, that is what I want to. You just select from that and you can edit this wall opening at any time as you want. So click that and select. So this is stable. So this is the wall opening for this particular area. Go to elevation, start elevation, and go and see it properly. So you can select it, adjust it, reinvent it, depends on your choice, whatsoever you want to do with this. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm extending it to this position. So that is for my own use technically, but I don't want to bring it to that point. So let me just select this, drag the entire wall down. So select the opening again, drag it down a bit. Good. So you can expand this. Let it expand. So I think I have it in this way to suit my design orientation. So for now I'm going to drag this one a little bit because I don't want them to have the same level of good. So I think I'm done with this as well. Select this. So this is how you set the elevation. You set it up for modification for people to see. So the same thing I'm going to do here as well. Select this. I'm dragging this one a little bit down than that one. Don't want them to have the same height. Good. So then can decide to push this up, but I'm not pushing it up now. So let it stay. This is what I have here. So now I want to use another pattern to work on this. So I'm creating this one and say create similar. Go to level one, then say create similar. So I'm going to use it here. I drop it here. I drop it there. Good. So let me just, I would not want it to cover the window, so let it slip a little bit and join. So let's say stay here, so you can like align it if it's possible. It's not going to be, because it's you having wall interlaying on each other. So if you want to align, just like sift it, okay, so you can like let it blend back. So here now you select this and say duplicates, the duplicate again, duplicates, and then edit. So edit the wall, come to the material references. So like choosing any of this one depends on your choice. You can just click this one and say duplicate two. So you duplicated that one, can change the figure if you don't want the two. I'm going to adjust to like this. No, let me just select normal brown. No, okay, let me just come to white tone. So I think black process. So you can select from here. Good. So I'm going to choose this black 4. Oh, sorry, something is happening there. So I'm going to choose black 4. For black 4, I'm choosing block 4. I'm not going to, I think, okay. So this is good for me. So I can decide to bring it down a bit, to let it be darker. Okay. So what is it? Say, unjoin the element. You can click unjoin. Delete the element. So what happened to deleting the element? So what is the issue? Good. So I think can now go to the 3D and see what we've created. So this is what we have done. Drag it off. Go back. So let's go to elevation. We shall see it properly. So we can drag it and join it. Then delete the element. What element is that? That's giving a leak. So do the same thing here. Good. So can still go further if you desire need it. So you can just like go more deeper and more further to do your bidding. So unjoin it, delete it. So that is it. So the elevation mark, they are all set and seen. So you can just cast shadow to see the reflection of what we've done. So this is it. So now we're done with this. Now I'm going to bring this one down by clicking go and say create similar for the ground floor plan. So align that from here to here as well. So bring it and then click OK. Align it to fit in. No, what is your issue? To set. Okay, don't leave it in that way. So click here and say elevation. This is what you've done. This is where the program has come. So you click here and drag it, change the perspective and the aligning method. So come there and rewrite the code. This way for it. So I am done with this one now. So what else do I need to do? I'm going to build up around this systematically and see how far I can go. So I will expand this towards here. Now while I go there, I will just say opening. So I'm going to open it for the wall. So I think I've opened that. So I'm going to select the open, expand it to this level, then expand it, drag it up, then drag it to the top where the, so click and let it switch the position where you want it to be. So that is it. You have that in place. So this is done for you. You have it in place. Then you go to your 3D and see the whole ideas of your elevation. So this is how the elevation design is. So we are still going to work on the details, setting up a wall lighting and things like that. So for now, this is how far we can see from this particular design process. So see you in the next elevation conclusion. Thanks for watching. God bless you.